All right, so today we're taking a look at the last section of chapter 8 for dealing with proportionality theorems. So the first one is the triangle proportionality theorem, which basically says if a line is parallel to one side of a triangle, intersects the other two sides, then it divides the two lengths proportionally. Okay, so all this is saying is if I give you a figure that looks like this, you guys, right here, if I give you that figure right there, you see that this line TU has been added in there, and it happens to be parallel to QS, all right? That's a given because of our parallel marks. All this is saying is if that is the case, then QT over TR or RT has the same ratio as US over UR, okay? So make sure you stay on the same side. So go from that point that is on there to the one side, and then the other, they go on the same side like we have right here. That is all the triangle proportionality theorem is saying. All right, the converse of the triangle proportionality theorem says if a line divides two sides of a triangle proportionally, then it is parallel to the third side. All right, so again, here's our figure. This is what they're going to give you. If you can prove that QT over TR has the same ratio or same proportion as US over UR, then you can say that QS is parallel to UT, okay? So it's basically working backwards. As long as your proportions are the same, the line is going to be parallel to that. All right, let's take a look at these first four questions. All right, and so for this first two, you need to show or find the length of AB. So it already tells me that these are parallel, BE and CD are parallel. So if they're parallel, that means I need to solve for AB, which is right there. So that's going to be X over 6, right? Because those are on the same length there, is equal to that of 5 over 10. Well, here we are just going to do our cross multiplication. So we have 5 times 6 is equal to 10X. So 30 is equal to 10x, divide by the 10, x is equal to 3 for that particular problem. All right, go ahead, pause the video, give number 2 a try. All right, number 2, x is right up there. So I'm going to do x over 7. Again, I stay on the same side length, but I just do the other part. My smaller one goes on top. My larger side length is going on the bottom there. So therefore, these two are the same. So we're going to cross multiply again. So we have 9x is equal to 14. Oh no, it doesn't come out to be a nice number. I don't know what to do. Deal with it. That's what you do. So it ends up just being 14/9, or if you really want to change it to 1 5/9, that is a fine by me. All right, so in number 3 down below, we have to determine if they are in fact parallel. Well, if they're parallel, that means these two here, 3/4, has to have the same ratio as those two. So if I do 4/5, no matter what I do, this is going to be 0.75. This is, no matter what I do, going to be 0.8. So no, they are not going to be proportional. Okay, so no, they are not going to be, they are not parallel because my ratios are not the same there. All right, go ahead and pause, give number 4 a try. All right, in number 4, if we set this up, we're going to have like 7.5 over 5. If you put it the other way around, that is fine. Okay, I'm going to do this one a little bit differently. You can still set it up as a proportion. So if you cross multiply, I get 30 when I multiply 5 times 6. I also end up with 30 when I do 7.5 times 4. So since those two equal the same number, 30 is equal to 30, that means they are a proportion. So that means, yes, AB is parallel to XY. And my reason is the converse triangle proportionality theorem. All right, let's take a look at the back side of our notes. All right, so at the top it says three parallel lines theorem. So all we need to remember for this is if we have three parallel lines intersect two different transversals, then they divide the transversals proportionally. All right, so here's what this is saying. We got to stay on the same line again, so I can do UW over WY, all right, would be equal to VX over XZ. You could also do UW over UY, so you could do like the longer length. Well, that needs to be the same proportion as VX over V2Z. All right, so it can be two smaller sections like we have right up here, or it can be a smaller section in the larger section like we have down below. All right, let's take a look a little bit further down. All right, so we're going to use this diagram to figure out what the missing proportion should be, or what's the missing side length for our proportion. So if we take a look at this, we have UV, so we have this, over UW, so that's the whole length. So I have XY, so then I need to do the entire length, which is going to be XZ for number one. For number two, let me erase those lines, that might help you. I have XY, so this is short, over YZ, so I have a short over short. They give me VW, so I need to do on top needs to be UV or VU, whichever way you want to write it. All right, let's see if you guys could figure out number three. All right, so number three, I have UW, so that's the whole length, over UV. And then they tell me ZY, well, I need to do the whole length, which would be ZX for that particular one. All right, let's take a look further down below. All right, so the last one is the triangle angle bisector theorem. If a ray bisects an angle of a triangle, then it divides the opposite side into segments whose length are proportional to the lengths of the triangle of the two sides. What is this even talking about? Okay, here's what it's talking about. Is you have this ray C to D that is coming through here like that. All right, we know it's an angle bisector because we have our little arc marks here and here. All this is saying, you guys, what are my two left side lengths? Well, I have AD. Well, AD would correspond over B to D or DB. That has to have the same ratio. Well, if I go along AD, I need to go along that part of the triangle as well. So that'd be what? CA over C to B, which is what I already have written down over there. But maybe sometimes it helps watching me write it out. All right, so we're going to use that information of the triangle angle bisector theorem to find the values of our variables down below, okay? So number one, hopefully, just don't make this harder than it needs to be. So here's one angle, and then here's its side length. So we're going to put those over the top of each other. So we have X over 5 is equal to, well, if I put X on top, what is the side length that's closest? That is 9 over, well, what's that side length close to? 15. So if we cross multiply here, we have 15x is equal to a 45. Divide both sides by 15, x is equal to 3. All right. Now, number 2 is a little bit different, only in because they don't give us what this value is from here to here. We can figure that out, however. Well, if we know the whole thing is 14, then this length is going to be 14 minus B. All right, because if you know, let's say I told you this side length over here was 8, you know then this would be what, 14 minus 8, which would be 6. All right, so we are going to go through, we're going to figure out what B is equal to. Well, again, if I go opposite of this, so I'm going to put B on top for one of them. On the bottom of that, well, what is this opposite of my bisected angle? Well, it is 14 minus B. All right, well, next to B is 9, so 9 is going to go on top. Next to this is my 6.75. So again, we're going to cross multiply again. So I have 6.75B is equal to 9, and then we have 14 minus B. So I need to distribute that through. So this is still 6.75B is equal to, well, this ends up being 126 minus 9B. All right, well, again, now we just got to get all of our B's on one side, so plus 9B to both sides. Well, this gets me to what, 15.75B is equal to 126. I'm going to divide both sides by 15.75 to get rid of my coefficient, fancy word. So B ends up being, man, was that ever a good guess. B is equal to 8. Ah, that's funny. I don't think I've, anyway, moving on. Have a good day.